Now, you thought we were completely done, but actually there's still a few loose ends to tie up. One is, can we really expect our residual to end up being exactly equal to zero? After all, the residual starts being the right-hand side B, and it keeps shrinking, and therefore we should be somewhat concerned about the fact that we could have catastrophic cancellation. And besides, in general, we typically never get an exact zero. So the stopping criteria that people tend to use is to say, let's instead look at the two norm of the current residual and compare that to some epsilon times the original right-hand side. And if that becomes small enough, then you say the method has converged. And you know, sometimes you don't quite get there, so typically people also put a maximum number of iterations on the method. So that's one thing. And the second thing is, well, when we talked about the method of steepest descent, we pointed out that it sure would be nice to accelerate it using a preconditioner. And just because we pick our search directions differently now, the fact is that using a preconditioner can greatly speed up how fast we converge with the conjugate gradient method. So typically people also add a preconditioning step to this. And that works just like it did when we talked about it in the setting of the method of steepest descent. Let me finish by pointing out that in one of the enrichments, we point to a nice little booklet that kind of walks you through all the kinds of different Krylov subspace-like algorithms, in other words, conjugate gradient-like algorithms that are out there, and that gives recommendations on when one should use what method. So be sure to check that out. You can actually download that book for free, so you might as well.